DD Dog from Littlest Pet Shop Kingdom News. And today, I am guest reporting for LISD TV, and I'm here to interview Maddy herself, the creator of LPS Pineapple Incorporated, your favorite yellow sugar glider in the pineapple hat.
Hi, my name is Maddy Ward, and I have a YouTube channel called LPS Pineapple Incorporated.
So, what is your channel about?
It's essentially about Littlest Pet Shops, which are these toys made by Hasbro, primarily the ones made in the earlier 2000s, but not totally. And my channel includes both story-based videos, such as short films and also multiple series. And I also do toy unboxings and reviews.
How did you get into this?
Well, my best friend actually introduced me to this LPS series called LPS Heart Failure, and I watched that one and many more from there. And I decided, hey, I could do this. I have some Littlest Pet Shops, and I've seen them at like garage sales and stuff, so I can like do this. And that's where it all started.
I'm wondering, when did you start?
I created my channel in 2014, but I don't think I started uploading until 2015.
How in the world have you gotten this far?
Well, I guess people like my content, and I've improved from using work lights with diffusion, with bulbs that diffuse light, to like actual softboxes, and I guess improving my audio quality by not filming when the dogs are barking in the background. But yeah, I've just improved, I guess, and people like it.
How do you interact with your fans?
I do have a Twitter and a Facebook page that I've been trying to get better at actually using, but for the most part, I mostly interact with fans on YouTube. I try to reply to all comments that I can give a reasonable response to, and I do read all of my comments. And yeah, that's really the best way for my fans to interact with me.
Now, how do your friends and family feel about it?
My parents were kind of like, oh, this is just a fun thing at first, but then I started monetizing, which means essentially making money off my videos from allowing YouTube to put ads on them. It's a bit more complicated than that, but that's the basics. And they were like, oh, this is like a legitimate thing, and now they're actually really supportive of it, and my friends are supportive of it too. My friend Sarah, which was actually the one who told me about LPS Tube to begin with, we've actually done multiple collabs, and she has a YouTube channel of her own with a... she does have a smaller following than me significantly, but it's still a whole lot of fun.
What is your creative process?
Well, I mostly have it, so then when I come up with an idea, I'll start writing a script, which isn't really like, it's not really a formal thing since it just has to be for me, since I'm basically doing this myself. But I storyboard pretty much where I essentially, it's essentially me playing with the LPS and figuring out stories. I'll like have, oh, this character is named this, this character is named this, and I'll put them in a scenario, like I'll have them walk into a coffee shop or whatever, and like, oh, here comes their sister. Oh, this is their friend. Oh, now we have to go to a birthday party. And a lot of these stories don't really go anywhere, but sometimes I'll actually come up with something interesting. Like actually my favorite short film I've made is Miss Pigman's Robots. And it's definitely it's my Halloween special I made this year. It's definitely my favorite. And yeah, that was one of the more interesting ideas.
Now, I'm curious, what is Miss Pigman's Robots about exactly?
Well, essentially, it's a Halloween video, so it centers around, you know, being scary. And the main character, Julia, is scared of these robots at this kind of, like, Chuck E. Cheese-inspired kind of arcade place. And yes, it is kind of similar to Five Nights at Freddy's. I have gotten comments about that. But, yeah, and I won't give away the ending, but I did try to keep it a surprise with the music and the tone and everything, and, yeah.
Let's say somebody else wanted to do this same thing you're doing. What advice would you give to them?
Try to improve your content. A lot of problems I see is people are like, oh my gosh, I wish I had your following, and then I'll go and look at their channel and I'm like, oh well, if you try and improve your lighting and maybe try and get something you can film a bit better with, and then they're like, oh well, the lighting's not that big of a deal, and I'm like, it is a big deal. And one other tip, if you can like make your content as good as possible, tags. Tags are a lot of things that people forget, and it doesn't matter how good your content is if nobody can find it.
Now, what else do you think people can do to market their videos?
The thumbnails and the title. As far as I know, they might have changed it, but when I started doing it, you could only have custom thumbnails if you were a YouTube partner, which means you monetize. And if you don't have custom thumbnails, then you just have the three options that YouTube gives you, and sometimes they're good, sometimes not so much. So you want to have like text, like if you're doing for instance, my recent Mega LPS haul, I had 100+ Littlest Pet Shops. It was like 107 or something. So I put in the thumbnail in bold red letters of a picture of all the LPS laid out with red arrows pointing to them, again in red text, 100+ pets, explanation point, explanation point, explanation point. So yeah, and then you put it again in the title, 100+ pets, and I had different types of pets, exclusive, rare, and sparkly, etc. So I put exclusive, rare, and sparkly, oh my. And yeah.
Now, tell me, Maddy, why use toys instead of real people?
It's the whole community and the fact that it's a lot easier to control a little toy than it is to do something live action. I can make a product, as long as you have the suspension of disbelief, oh, they're animals and you're controlling them with your hand and or a stick, depending on what technique you're using. As long as you have that suspension of disbelief, I can make a way better product than I would be able to with the same stuff live action.
How do you edit your videos?
I've only ever used Premiere Pro, like in the class and with you guys, LISD TV, but because I don't really have that at home, I edit with this software that I bought called Wondershare Filmora. It's one of those things where you buy it once and then you keep it, because it would be a lot more expensive to get Premiere Pro, and it's easier. I can make videos quicker with that because I can add special effects with their drag and drop thing. And obviously there's a lot less you can do with Filmora, but since a lot of its demographic are YouTubers, I find it's a lot easier to use for my channel. But that might be changing if I can get Premiere Pro or something.
Now I'm really wondering, how has your editing progressed from the beginning?
Well, actually, when I first started my channel, I used Windows Movie Maker, and then I'm like, this is not gonna cut it anymore. So then I got Filmora, and now I'm looking into possibly getting Premiere Pro and using it for certain videos. I'm probably still not gonna use it for like my quick fire like toy openings or anything, because that doesn't really matter. With that, it's probably going to be about the same, because all I have to do is chop off the ends of the clips. Yeah, I'm trying to decide whether to switch over. I probably won't completely, but yeah.
Thank you, Maddy. And now I'm Diddy Dog, signing off.